Greetings. Heavenly Father, I thank you for YouTube and the gift it has become in these last days. Wow, the internet has sure made the world smaller. As believers, we should study to show ourselves approved to God, workmen that are not ashamed because of our lack of knowledge. 2 Timothy 2:15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. It should be a joy for us to store the word of God in our hearts. Psalm 119:11. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. Psalm 119:105. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light unto my path. Too often we get caught up looking at the future, neglecting the right now. Matthew 6:34. Therefore, don't worry about tomorrow, because tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. But how do we, as Christians, harmonize that verse with this? 1 Thessalonians 5:2. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so comes as a thief in the night. But you, brethren, are not in darkness, that the day should overtake you as a thief. Clearly, there are signs that should be easy to recognize as the day approaches. But God does not want you to worry or fret. It is far too easy to get wrapped up emotionally in fear when you see events unfolding. It can easily overwhelm when you begin to try and carry on your shoulders the load to fix all these problems. How can I stop them, you might ask? What can I be doing to prepare? John 14:1. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in Jesus. John 14:18. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. You see, you have Almighty God living inside you. You do not have to see Him or feel Him. He is there. Hebrews 13:5. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as you have, for He has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you, so that we may boldly say, The Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what men shall do unto me. The Word of God says we boldly say such things because of the confidence we have in Him. Psalm 118:8. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. And verse 9. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. 2 Timothy 1:12. Therefore I endure these things, and I am not ashamed, for I know in whom I have believed, and I am convinced that He is able to keep my trust for me until that day. Romans 8:39. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Psalm 21:1. Joy in the salvation of Yahweh. For the music director, a psalm of David. O Yahweh, the king will rejoice in your strength, and how greatly he will delight in your help. Christians, pray for Muslims. The devil has blinded them. They say they respect Prophet David. They say they respect the Psalms, that the Psalms were given by God. But they are blind in every way, and only God can open their eyes. Only the Word of God can bring light to their darkness. I want to encourage you, Christian. You have been bought with a price. You are not your own any longer. 1 Corinthians 6:20. For you were bought with a price. Therefore glorify God with your body. 1 Corinthians 7:23. You were bought at a price. Do not become slaves of men. You are no longer your own, And that is a liberating thought. Galatians 2:20, I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. In a way, your life is no longer your responsibility. Matthew 6:19, lay not up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust does corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. If your heart and your mind are all fixed on your future, your plans, your 401k, your IRA, your retirement, you are setting yourself up for remorse, sadness, frustration, anger, and bitterness. We will likely see all that stripped away in the coming years. If that is where your heart is, you will suffer loss, trauma, devastation, and even despair. Believers, I encourage you to seriously examine what your heart is fixed upon. Let the Word of God guide, frame, form, and shape your thinking. Romans 12:2, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect. Do not let the world press you into its mold. That includes pagan religions like Islam that have no regard for Yahweh, the God of Abraham. Let us continue to hold firmly to the hope that we confess without wavering, for the one who made the promise is faithful. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything, to stand. For you have need of endurance, so that when you have done the will of God, you may receive what was promised. Because in a very short time, he who is coming will come and will not delay. And he is coming soon. I believe in our lifetimes. I believe not 10 years hence. But I'll talk about that in a future video. For now, there will be signs in sun and moon and stars, and on the earth dismay among nations, in perplexity at the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will be terrified at what they see coming upon the earth, for the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. But when these things begin to take place, stand up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is near. So lift up your head and look up with great expectation. And he who is the faithful witness to all these things says, yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. May the Spirit of God give you encouragement and fill your heart with His joy. May your love for God be renewed like the love of your youth. And may He open your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, in a new and fresh way. Amen.